Hi there. Welcome to another edition of Heat Smart with Portage and Main. Today it's about the 1st of October and we're in the company greenhouse just checking out some of the growth in here, picking the last few things off of our vines. We've got some nice cucumbers over here, tomatoes here. Behind me, a lot of melons and green peppers, things like that. Now, why are we in here today? What are we going to talk about? We're going to talk about energy. Now, in North America, our food system is heavily dependent on fossil fuel energy for production. There's both the cost of fuel for tractors and the maintenance on tractors. There is the pesticides, herbicides, fertilizers, all derived from fossil fuels. And then, of course, the transportation to market of the products also requires fossil fuels, petroleum, gasoline, diesel, to get that to market. Now, the unfortunate part about that is that in a lot of instances, in fact, most instances in the North American food economy, it takes more energy to produce food than the food itself actually contains, putting us into an energy deficit situation, if you will. A fine example I just read here the other day was what it took to get a head of lettuce from the US to the UK by plane. It turns out that to get 1 calorie of lettuce energy to the UK from the US requires 127 calories of fossil fuel energy to get it there. Now, if you're any kind of businessman, that's more cost than there is profit, really, in the terms of calories. So we have to be really questioning what's going on with our food industry and whether or not that whole process is even sustainable. Now, in this case here, we're using one of Portage and Main's fine outdoor boilers to provide heat for our workshop, our office space, and a residence on the property as well. Now, we still have enough surplus heat energy here to provide nice warm growing conditions on the shoulder seasons for our greenhouse. And that serves two really great purposes because our boilers like to run hard as often and as long as they can. And sometimes in the spring and fall, you don't need that much of a heating load in your home to keep it a nice comfortable temperature. So you have this potential to make more heat, but you don't use it. And sometimes that can be hard on your boiler, cause it to run inefficiently. So if you throw a greenhouse loop on there, you're actually doing yourself two favors. You're saving energy in the form of your fuel, and you're also providing good, healthy food close to home. Most people think about energy security and reducing their carbon footprint. They think about maybe driving their vehicle less, taking the bus once in a while, maybe riding their bike. Now, all of those things are great, but they overlook what it costs to get their food to them and what energy is being used to create and harvest that food. Now, there's a really great book written by B.M. Green in 1978 called Eating Oil. And I've got some really great excerpts out of that book that explain how our food system is dependent on oil, and without oil and gas, petroleum, our current food model wouldn't exist. Now, 100 years ago, almost everybody took care of their own food needs. They grew gardens, they did canning, preservation, they gathered, they hunted, they raised livestock. Today, that doesn't happen so much. We sit at our desk jobs for 8-10 hours a day. We go home and we don't do anything to support ourselves. We rely on other people and fossil fuels to get the job done. I had a scary thing happen in the produce section of my local grocery store last year. I went in and the shelves and displays were virtually empty. There were people fighting over the last few avocados and lemons that were still on display, but other than that, the place was empty. I went to my produce manager and I said, "What happened?" And he said, "Well, our trucks didn't come in today." And that kind of scared me. "Today?" I thought. He said, "Yeah, trucks come in every day bringing us our produce. And if they don't come in, we don't have anything to sell." And I got thinking about that. The store only has like one day of food in it. Yet we rely on these things every day to keep us fed. Now, that puts us in a bit of a vulnerable situation, don't you think? Should there be a natural disaster, a road washout, or if we do have another oil crunch really badly and fuel prices go through the ceiling? I would like to see everybody doing this, you know, growing some food for themselves, taking care of their families, putting the time in to, you know, get in touch with Mother Nature and provide for themselves. I think that everybody has an obligation to handle their own food security in a responsible and sustainable manner. One way that we can do that is by purchasing locally sourced food. When you're going to the supermarket, grocery store, take a look at where things were produced and try and get stuff that was made closer to you so that there's less embodied energy and fossil fuel consumption to get that to your table. Whenever you can, try and grow some food, whether it's in your front flower bed or in a greenhouse like this. Now here at Portage and Main, we'd like to see new greenhouses going up all over the country that were using the sun's power and locally sourced renewable energy sources like wood chips, biomass, solid fuel like logs, to create food in your local area. Our current food system is inefficient, unsustainable, and effectively unreliable. Thanks for watching this episode of Heat Smart with Portage and Main. Stay tuned for more exciting and informative episodes, and make sure you eat your vegetables.